breakfast. The Commerce Commission is taking loan provider Moola to the High Court following accusations that it's failing to treat borrowers responsibly and ethically. Moola denies the allegations and claims it is a strong focus on compliance. Joining us now to explain what appropriate compliance actually involves and to provide some context around money lending market is FinCap Chief Executive Tim Barnett. Good morning.
Good morning, Hayley. How are you?
Very good, thank you. So the Commerce Commission are commencing High Court proceedings. What do you make of this?
Oh, we're really pleased that the Commerce Commission has done this. I mean, I think the fact has taken 4 years from the initial complaint until it actually reaches this stage shows how the system isn't working like it should. But really happy that the move's being taken. And what the Commerce Commission is doing, we feel, is to really test law, which has needed testing for a long time, which obliges these companies to check on affordability, to ask why people are borrowing the money in the first place, and making a decision on that basis. And clearly they're saying in the case of Moola is that they failed on a whole range of counts. I mean, it's a pretty astonishing range of charges, including that Moola failed to make inquiries to be satisfied of the borrower's ability to repay without substantial hardship. And of course, when you're borrowing something at hundreds of percent, it's pretty likely that something will go wrong. And we feel the whole model of these companies is based on that happening.
What sort of changes would you like to see? There is the Credit Contracts and Consumer Finance Amendment Bill being tabled by Chris Farfoy. What sort of changes would you like to see in that?
Well, we'd like these tests to be a bit tighter, and that's in the bill. We certainly respect what's already being proposed by government, which is that you won't have to repay more than 100% of what you borrow. So you borrow 500, you won't have to repay more than 1,000, and that's good. However, if the government aren't proposing a cap on interest rates, and we're saying unless there is a cap which is absolutely enforceable, which by its nature an interest rate cap would be, then that's problematic. So in the case of these companies, because Moola is one of maybe 20, 25 companies who are charging high interest loans at that end of the market, if you have an interest rate cap of 50%, which leaves most of the loan companies, the banks and others untouched, then that actually deals with this massively harmful product where people are paying 200, 500, 600% to borrow money, are regularly getting into trouble, are reborrowing, and at the end of the day, more often than not, end up with a debt collector, which ends up in a whole lot of new problems for them. And we think the product is so dangerous that it's better to actually set a cap and move off in a different direction and create new products which are safer for people.
So you're saying that these products are actually contributing to what people call the debt spiral. So they're getting into a trouble situation and they need emergency money and it just gets worse.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we checked with our, we've got 200 budget services around the country. They see 70,000 people a year. Half those people will have accessed one of these type of loans in the last year. And of those people, half ended up getting a second loan out. Of them, half ended up with a debt collector. And 90% of the services said these products are so harmful, it'd be better if they weren't on the market. So we're pretty clear. We've got that mandate from the people who know it on the ground to get the kind of interest rate cap which is needed. And we hope Parliament's going to be brave enough in the next few weeks to make that decision.
Well, they may have heard you today, hopefully. Tim Barnett from FinCap. Thank you very much.
Thank you.